We passed a bill about the national voter registration changes. We find that in L.A. there's 1.6 million people more on the voter rolls than actually old enough to live there. We had COVID, where people made decisions where they just mailed ballots to everybody. You read Article 2, any changes made has to be approved by the legislature. Now, for the last, since 1988, every time it's come before Congress, the Democrats have challenged, it's your time. And Nancy Pelosi said, this is democracy. This is our time that we can talk about the integrity and look to ways to improve. I know what that mob did was un-American. Denounced it, fought through it. They broke into my window. They stole my stuff. I had to take my staff to get out of the building through it. Officers also left. We have nothing to do with that.
Yeah. Was the president?
We have a constitutional right to debate it, just as the Democrats have, just as Clyburn voted to throw out Ohio. John Lewis did. What we debated Arizona and Pennsylvania would not change the outcome of the election.
Did the president play any role
in
what happened?
ABC did you listen to my speech today?
Well, I did. And ABC is reporting that the president told you that he had a little responsibility. Is that true? And when's the last time you spoke to the president?
2 days ago. Look, I spoke to the president during the riot. I was the first person to call him. I told him to go on national TV, tell these people to stop it. He said he didn't know what was happening. Went to the news then to work through that. I asked the president if he has any responsibility. You know what? The president does, but you know what? All of us do also.
So if he had a responsibility.
For the last 5 years, watch what people say on social media. When the president was elected, what they say? Resist. What does Maxine Waters says to get into our faces? The Democrats never accepted the presidency for the last 4 years. Every American has a responsibility. That's why in my speech today, I went back to the 1800s.
But Congressman, if you're saying that the president told you he played a small responsibility and you believe he played a small responsibility, how can you differ with Mitch McConnell and Liz Cheney in the House who believe that he committed, let me finish, they believe he committed impeachable offenses?
They believe. Okay, then let's walk through it. Have you read his speech? He says to go up and demonstrate peacefully.
Yes, and he lied to his people and said that he was walking with them when in fact he got into a bulletproof limousine and went in the opposite direction.
Because
he lied to them again.
The Secret Service said he couldn't. Okay, then watch for one moment. The language you use on your radio show, if somebody goes does something after they listen to your show, even though you said demonstrate peacefully, are you liable?
If I know it's a radical group of people that are listening to me on that day,
so then,
yes,
but
I would have incited something. If I said, let's go down to City Hall and get Karen Go. If I knew that a radical bunch of folks, like the radicals that were listening to him, I would be held responsible.
Okay, now listen. He didn't say go get the members. What he did, rally. I say he has responsibility. He told me personally that he does have some responsibility. I think a lot of people do. But now that I find out, and the one thing about impeachment, why would you run it through so fast? I say let's put a bipartisan commission. Let's learn all the facts. Does the Sergeant of Arms have a fault in this because he wouldn't bring in the National Guard? When they found the IEDs earlier in the morning, why didn't they call the FBI? When they planned all before, how were those people ever able to storm this building? Now I'm finding out the FBI warned the Capitol Police that they had knowledge of individuals saying they wanted to do certain things. The president never had that. I never had that. These people had it pre-planned before the speech.
All right, fine, Congressman.
So
to be honest with you, Kevin, Congressman, I'd rather talk about the president's culpability. Is it true that you went to Steny Hoyer and tried to work out a censure agreement?
Yes.
So then you feel that the president is responsible for what happened?
I feel he has some responsibility. That's why I think censure rises to that level. But is he?
But it's not impeachable?
You're thinking
it's not an impeachable offense?
He did not say go in. I don't know. I don't believe it's an impeachable offense. No. And you know what else? In the history of America, I think this is a moment in time where he's sitting a week away from going in, where he's leaving. The Senate cannot even take it up. In the 1800s, Adams, the most probably divisive election we ever had, when Jefferson. You know what they did? They united. And you know what Jefferson said? Forgive. This is our moment in time to really go to a place where this America can heal. And that is what I told the president, and that's what I told Joe Biden's campaign, and that's what's best for America. What is impeachment going to do to this nation? Is it going to bring
it would send a message.
Together? Is it going to
it would
answer?
Send it would
and
send a
you
message.
You can't do impeachment on a fast course. You ought to have the facts. Do we have all the facts, or is it emotional? Do you dislike the president? Did you dislike his speech? But in his speech, did he say go hang somebody? Did he say go break into the building?
He threw Mike Pence under the bus.
Where it is.
Congressman, he threw Mike Pence under the bus and lied again and implied or insisted that Mike Pence could overturn the election when my 13-year-old nephew knows the vice president couldn't flip the election. He told those people, "We hate Mike Pence because he can't overturn the because he won't overturn the election when he couldn't." And those people, Kevin, wait. Congressman, those people went down and screaming, "Hang Mike Pence," when 2 days ago he was a hero within the Republican Party, simply by saying Mike Pence should do something that he can't even do. He incited this crowd to go down there, and they were chanting, "Hang Mike Pence."
Did he tell the crowd to hang him? What he said Mike Pence could do, he could not do.
Well, then why would he say that? Why in the world would the President of the United States say something that even a 15-year-old high school person knows?
Is that impeachable what people say every day on the floor that I believe is wrong?
Well, the leader of the Senate.
People question the integrity of the election. That's what we do. We debate.
All right, I'm not going to.
And you got to lower the temperature, bring the nation together. What I think the correct approach to do. Have a bipartisan commission to have all the information before you choose the outcome.
What more information do we need, Congressman?
Okay, let's find out who planned to get in this building, how they got in the building, and how the failure is.
Well, we definitely need to do that. But we need
name
to,
me in
we
that
need...
speech where he says, if you dislike the president, that's one thing. But you know what? If you believe in the rule of law, follow what impeachment says.
What about Rudy Giuliani?
To the level, I believe it rises to the level of censure. So I said, let's go to censure.
All right. Have you seen, again, we're talking with Congressman Kevin McCarthy. We appreciate him taking time on an incredible day inside the Beltway. Have you seen, I don't take much stock in polls, but have you seen the unprecedented poll that KGET has taken? They claim that 6,330 people call their television station, which is absolutely unprecedented. And 67% of the people that called said that you should resign.
Is that a scientific poll?
No, I led with
that. If you want to do a call-in on your show, I can guarantee you I can get 99% if I want to, because I can go and make the calls.
Right.
We know I'm coming off an election at 62%, the highest of any Republican congressman in California. You know that we just didn't lose one Republican in all of Congress.
Yeah, you had a great night. That's why I can't understand.
If you read the poll at the very beginning, I didn't have such a great night, right? Because this election's different than anyone else, right? It's the early absentees where they mailed everybody in California. And you know what I got every single day? People on Facebook sending me photos of ballots sent to their house they didn't request, from parents that were no longer living, from people who no longer live there, because one person decided that we're going to mail all the ballots out. These are the type of questions, and there's certain states that did that. Don't we want to have accuracy, accountability, and integrity in our election? And is it wrong to have a debate on that? Even the debate we had couldn't change the outcome of the election, but it's the moment in time we can have the debate.
People are shocked, Congressman, at least word around the campfire, as I like to say, that it was one thing for you to support this, and I supported the challenge, but once it went to the courts, once it went past, and after the mob, after the insurrection, you still went in and voted for flipping the election.
That's a very good question, and you got to understand the answer. Okay, so if I wanted to change my position before the mob wanted to intimidate me, you would say my position was political. But if my position was based upon principle, that I wanted to have a debate about it, and I had a debate about it, I didn't change it. That's a fundamental difference. I was debating on principle, not on politics.
Do you fear a fight for your leadership? Liz
not
Cheney...
At all.
She's number three, and she said,
not at all.
Let's just what Liz Cheney said. The president of the United States summoned this mob, assembled the mob, and lit the flame of this attack. Everything followed was his doing. None of this would have happened without the president. It's the biggest betrayal in American history. Do you fear she's going to try to take the pro-impeachment folks in the Republican Party, and you'll be stuck with those who don't think this was impeachable?
No. You know what happened just a few days prior, Ralph? I had every single Republican vote for me for Speaker. I came a few votes short. Never in modern history has any leader on the Republican side ever had that.
But
Do we have turmoil right now? Yes. Is the ability to unite it? Yes. If you listen to my speech on the floor today, I think most people agree with exactly what I said, that the president does have some responsibility. Does it rise to impeachment? No. Are there a few days left? Yeah, and it's probably not the right thing to do, unite the nation at this moment in time. Also, did I support a bipartisan commission? Did I support censure? Yes. I think most Americans believe they're looking for someone who's working forward to solve the challenge.
So you don't fear you're going to be on the wrong side of history on this thing?
Not
and
at all.
When, in a year or two.
What did I do that's wrong in history? That I had.
You've got members of your party who believe that the president committed an impeachable act, and you disagree. And
okay,
I think there's a growing.
I can't disagree with somebody that I'm wrong in history.
Well, I think there's a growing feeling.
What the law says about impeachment.
There's a growing feeling.
He did not say to go in.
There's a growing feeling among your constituents, I believe, that he did commit impeachable offenses.
Okay, well, name the impeachable offense.
Inciting a riot.
He incited the riot.
Kevin, the lead headline on the Los Angeles Times was Trump incited mob.
So now we choose impeachment based upon what the Los Angeles Times says, or why don't we go to the words that the person spoke? And why, if we're going to go impeachment, why don't we follow the impeachment process? Why don't we go to a committee? Why don't we have a hearing? What I do as a member of Congress and every member of Congress when it comes to impeachment is be a grand jury. And you know what a grand jury gets to do? They get to have witnesses. They get to ask questions. They get to see whether it's going forward. Have we had any of that? No, we predetermined it. So what I proposed, which I think history will say I'm right because it's the right thing to do, I believe, have a bipartisan commission and get all your facts. Actually work through the grand jury to find out at the end instead of predetermining whether someone's guilty or not.
And then what?
I don't think that's healthy for America.
And then what? What after this investigation, after this probe, after this
then
commission,
then what? Then you can make the decision. Then you have the information before you. But the information I have before me right now, and I've walked through it, I've read the transcript, I watched the speech. He said go demonstrate. He used the word peacefully. Now, I think it's wrong that if you take the mass part of that crowd, now I'm finding out from the FBI, every day I learn something more, that the FBI already warned people that there were people in there that were going to try to break in. So if they were already planning to break in before you claim what is impeachment, before he even spoke, how does that play into it then? Wouldn't you want all the information? Wouldn't you want to have that day before you make that such serious decision?
All right.
I would.
I fear for you, Congressman. As a friend and as a constituent, I fear for you.
Why do you fear for me?
I feel like you're on the wrong side of history.
All right.
I really do. Final, and you kind of answered this. I'll let you go. And again, I really appreciate you taking the time. And you kind of answered this, but exactly where were you when this whole thing broke out? Where did your detail take you, if you can tell us that?
I can't tell you where I went as security, but I was in the Capitol. I got a report that they broke on the west side. We're having the debate. Now, my office is the closest to the chambers. I'm watching the debate. I've got another member in here talking to me, and my detail tells me we need to go. They've broken through the other way. I said, I'm not going. I'm staying. They start breaking a window in my office. They start breaking another door, and they said, we cannot stay here. I take my staff. They had moved other offices' staff into my office because it's the closest to there. We had to move because they had taken over the Capitol, and my office is in the Capitol. We had to run through different staircases that they were coming the other way through. intense times. That is when I got to a certain point, a certain place beyond. I mean, we had to do a lot of twists, a lot of turns, a lot of different staircases, turning back around. The mob was coming another direction. We were probably the last people out through certain staircases before it was taken over. They did go into my office. They did steal things. They did break through the windows.
Yeah. Do you think this was premeditated? Because the Congress, it's a very complicated building.
How they found your office
and Pelosi's office. And
yeah. If you could take the president out of it, let's just have another discussion. What this mob did was just show other nations how they can take over the Capitol. What this mob just did, and they had a lot of pre-planning. They had a pre-planning about from the National Guard and all of these different things. But because what happened in the summer, and this is what I don't want to say certain things. That's why I want all the commission to find out what happened. Why wasn't the National Guard in earlier? One person has said because of what happened in the summer, the mayor didn't want him around. The sergeant at arms pretty much in the House worked just for the speaker. Somebody has laid different things out, saying they didn't want to call because of the way it looked. These men and women in the uniform, they got overrun. One officer got killed. I went down and said they got broken arms. You don't understand what was transpiring at that moment in that time. People hanging. People brought ropes. When I got back into my building, I found the straps that they had. I don't know if they're coming to try to kidnap somebody or whatever, but they were well planned for it.
So
if you say the speech caused it, these people are already planned for it. And so there is a failure at some point because we have protests all the time here. The reason why when my security said to go and I said, I'm not going, I felt very, very secure in this place. You know, I've watched it time and again. But this is at a different point and a different time, and people had real worked out plans. They scaled walls. They brought ropes. A couple of the protesters died because they scaled, and when you have the inaugural, they were scaffolding. They were scaling the scaffolding. They overtook the place.
Yeah.
And had it been better planned, none of this would have happened. And if none of this would have happened, you and I would be talking about a debate. We'd still be talking about Biden becoming president.
Yeah.
We wouldn't be talking about any of this other stuff.
Final, I'll let you go, and I've held you over much longer than we agreed, and I appreciate that. So this really is final. Full disclosure, we're taping this at 11:49, so 12:12. It's 2:49, almost 3 o'clock back there. What's going to happen today?
The Democrats with a smaller group of Republicans will pass for impeachment that will go to the Senate. Even if you talk to the Democrats, a lot of them have come to me and said they didn't want to do this, that Pelosi wouldn't let them use censure, that she just wanted to impeach again because it won't get brought up in the Senate beforehand. It doesn't help heal the nation. I don't really believe Joe Biden wants this to happen. If you think about it, when it goes into the Senate, it's not going to be taken up to January 20th, and you have to take it up. So it's going to slow down a trial of any of the new cabinets being filled. It's not what is best for the nation.
Is it true that Biden went to McConnell and said, can we do both?
I don't know that.
Well, all right.
I don't think that.
Yeah. Thank you again. Be careful. Take care.
You can disagree.
Yes, sir.
It doesn't mean history is different. The great thing about this nation is people have differences of opinion. But the one thing that keeps us together is we believe in the rule of law. Have the facts, then make your determination. What happened in this Capitol should never happen again. Anybody that participated needs to go to court, needs to go to jail. We have been clear about that from day one. There is nothing in the process from the day I got out of here, inside the Capitol part. I called the president to him, bring the National Guard, go on television at that moment in this. And I went on all the national news to tell him what I told him. To have them go on.
Do you fear the inauguration, and will you be attending?
I will be attending. The inauguration will be much smaller and different because of COVID.
Do you fear violence?
You don't know what this Capitol looks like now. I've been to tour and look at our troops in Afghanistan and Iraq. There's troops everywhere. Now, normally in an inaugural, they put up a lot of fencing and they wall people out, all the different protections. But where we are in this nation, and that's the one thing you have to think about. You know what changed with impeachment on the floor today? The Democrats changed the rules so you could say anything personal about anybody you want just for the next 3 days.
Do you fear violence? And there are reports that there'll be violence not only in Washington but in capitals
all over the state capitals.
Yeah.
I'm worried of the nation. And so does impeachment right now If I could use your same question, doing impeachment right now, a week away from inaugural, when you have that information to other capitals, is history going to say that was the right thing to do? Or would history look to the 1800s and say, stand with Adams and Jefferson and do what they did?
Very good.
Accept that the other person won, accept forgiveness, and move to the better angels of America.
Again, thank you so much for taking time. Good luck. Be careful.
Right.
And we really appreciate it.
Good to hear from you, Ralph. Take care.
Always good to talk to you, sir. Take care. Kevin McCarthy, everybody.
I'm Ed Horrell.